You're watching Get Cruise Ship Info and More. We will be discussing 8 key topics in today's cruise news update for March 24, 2021. So stay tuned and enjoy the scenery while you get your daily dose of cruise news. But before we jump right into the video, please make sure you subscribe to my channel and like this video to stay updated with the latest news from the cruise industry and much more. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Global Ports Holding Strategic Partner in Caribbean Cruise Restart, Nassau Cruise Port, managed by Global Ports Holding PLC, will serve as critical partner in the restart of cruise tourism in the Caribbean in June and July 2021. Both Crystal Cruises and Royal Caribbean International will use Nassau Cruise Port as a home port as they relaunch Caribbean cruising. NCP falls under the GPH portfolio, said it was seeing interest in using Antigua as a home port as well, which also falls under its management. This opportunity could not have been achieved without a strong commitment to the trilateral partnership between key contributors to this process, Nassau Cruise Port Limited, the government of the Bahamas, and cruise line partners. NCP collaborates with the government to contribute to policy and regulation development to ensure that the best interests of our communities are maintained. The government collaborates with the cruise lines on health protocols, contractual matters, and other details to ensure a mutually beneficial partnership exists on an ongoing basis. And NCP works with the cruise lines to ensure that their operational, passenger experience, and other needs are met at the port. It takes a lot of teamwork, coordination, listening, and flexibility to achieve such effective collaboration. At its peak, vessels that home port here will potentially bring thousands of new passengers to Nassau annually, which is not only significant for us but for other local industry players as well. This opening will generate an extensive amount of economic activity for hotels, tour operators, taxis, and other tourism stakeholders as this area of our business grows. In Nassau, home port operations will begin amid ongoing construction as general contractor ANCA completes the marine works and launches plans to start the upland development. The ability to give cruise lines the option to homeport presents a massive opportunity for Nassau and Antigua, making partnerships with our ports even more critical in influencing the regional success of the industry. UnCruise to run fully vaccinated Alaska and Pacific Northwest cruises into O2-1 UnCruise Adventures has announced it will offer only fully vaccinated sailings in Alaska and the Pacific Northwest. Starting from 2021, Dan Blanchard, CEO of UnCruise Adventures, said that he wants people to know Alaska is open, wide open. Alaska has the highest vaccination rate in the nation, and they can't wait to share their wild natural areas with guests. Their decision to move to fully vaccinated cruises will help guests and crew experience Alaska in the safest way possible. UnCruise Adventures also said that it would likely be one of a few small ship companies operating in Alaska in 2021. The cruise line will operate a series of 7, 12, and 14-night sailings around Alaska in May-September 2021, and 7-night voyages in the Pacific Northwest in May-October 2021. P&O reports overwhelming number of bookings for UK coastal cruises, mentioned in a press release. P&O Cruises has reported an overwhelming number of bookings for its summer season of UK coastal cruises since they went on sale on the morning of March 22. Many thousands of guests have already made bookings, and the Iona's maiden voyage to the Scottish Islands is already very well sold and will be a very special cruise. The 3, 4 and 7-night cruises on the flagship Britannia and the new ship Iona built by the cruise line as the ultimate British break will set sail from Southampton between June and September. Where else but by sailing with us on the Iona can you taste Spanish specialty tapas from Jose Pizarro, fine wines chosen by Ollie Smith, Marco Pierre White's Beef Wellington, and award-winning Snowflake Gelato? And that's before you choose from a new movie release in the boutique cinema or catch a show in Skydome or a music set 710 Club. There's certainly no other domestic holiday this year which can compete. Costa Cruises to start cruising again in May 2021. Costa Cruises announced that it will start cruising again in May, citing restrictions in place in Europe and other European countries to contain COVID-19. In line with the new plan, the Costa Smeralda's departure from Italy is planned for May 1st, with 3- and 4-day mini cruises or alternatively a 7-day cruise. Calling at Savona, La Spezia, Civitavecchia, Naples, Messina, and Cagliari, from June 12, the Costa Smeralda will return to sailing one-week cruises in the Western Mediterranean, with visits to Italy Savona, Civitavecchia, and Palermo, France Marsal, and Spain Barcelona and Palma de Mallorca. The departure date of Costa Luminosa, the second Costa ship scheduled to resume service, is now postponed to May 16 from Trieste, and the following day from Bari, confirming its program of one-week cruises in Greece and Croatia. HBO to premiere documentary on Diamond Princess's COVID outbreak, though, has announced the debut of its new documentary, The Last Cruise, on March 30. According to the company, the movie is a first-person account of the coronavirus outbreak that transpired on board the Diamond Princess, which set sail from Japan in the earliest days of the COVID-19 pandemic. The Diamond Princess went on a 16-day cruise round trip from Japan on January 20, 2020. It had 2,666 guests on board, of which about a half were Japanese residents, and 1,045 crew members. Three American couples feature in The Last Cruise, telling their stories, as well as several crew members. The Last Cruise will be available for viewing on HBO Max. The film is directed and produced by Hannah Olsen. Norwegian cancels select voyages through November due to redeployment. Norwegian Cruise Line has cancelled all voyages on the Norwegian Encore, Jewel, and Jade through October-November 2021 due to fleet redeployment. This was announced in a letter sent to the cruise line's passengers on March 22. They will receive the reimbursement in the form of, according to the letter, the following sailings have been cancelled. All sailings with embarkation dates before October 28, 2021, on the Norwegian Encore. All sailings with embarkation dates before October 6, 2021, on the Norwegian Jewel. All sailings with embarkation dates before November 4, 2021, on the Norwegian Jade. Royal Caribbean adds second ship to North American start from Bermuda. Royal Caribbean International is not wasting any time in starting up in North America, as the Vision of the Seas will start cruising from Bermuda in June 2021. She joins the Adventure of the Seas, which will also start up in June from Nassau. The Vision will offer 7-night itineraries from June 26 through August 28. The cruises will sail to Perfect Day at Kokoke and call at Bermuda's Royal Naval Dockyard for 2 nights. The itinerary will feature 3 days at sea. Similar to the Adventures program, it is expected guests over the age of 18 will need to be vaccinated, while guests under 18 will need to show proof of a negative COVID-19 test. Bookings will open on March 29. Silversea's 2023 World Cruise is sold out. Silversea Cruises has shattered its bookings record with its new 2023 World Cruise, entitled Southside Story, All the World's a Stage. Following the most successful pre-sale in the cruise line's history, the 139-day voyage fully sold out on the day of its general opening. The immersive voyage will take guests deep into the Southern Hemisphere, sailing from the South Seas to the Amazon rainforest and beyond, calling in 66 destinations in 34 countries across 5 continents. Following a bond voyage reception and dinner aboard the intimate, all-suite Silver Shadow, guests will depart Sydney on January 10, 2023, and arrive in Fort Lauderdale on May 28. The itinerary will present a unique mix of destinations, from the remote wonders of Papua New Guinea, Mauritius, Reunion Island, and Cape Verde to iconic regions and cities, often unlocked on overnight calls, 20 in total, including 10 days spent exploring Tasmania and New Zealand, 3 days in Myanmar, and a full week in South Africa. And, for the first time on a Silversea World Cruise, Silver Shadow will sail the Amazon River to unlock the natural and cultural wonders of this legendary region. And with that, we wrap up our cruise news updates for March 24th. If you enjoyed this cruise news update, subscribe to my channel and like to this video would really be appreciated. I shall see you soon. Until then, please take care and stay safe.